In this video, we're going to be talking about a checklist that you can use when you're packing for a trip with your baby. We're going to be talking about carry-on stuff and suitcase stuff. Right, Kai?
Yeah.
Yeah. Recently, I went on my first international trip with my four-month-old. We went to England and Malta, and it was a really good trip. You can see how the flying experience went in the video that is going to pop up right now in the corner. Before we left for our trip, I started to plan what I was going to bring for this trip for her, like a week in advance, which is not typically what I do. Usually I pack the day before, if not the day of, leaving on a trip because I've been doing it so many times for so many years. I feel like it's like second nature to me. I don't even really need to think when I pack for myself. But for her, it was a different story. So I'm gonna be sharing in this video what I brought with me, which I'm so glad that I brought with me because there are other things that you don't end up using. So I'm not gonna mention those in this video. I'm just gonna mention the stuff that came in handy. So get ready, and if you head on over to our blog, you can actually download a PDF checklist for when you're packing to travel with your baby. Okay, let's break this up. What are we taking in our carry-on bag or the diaper bag? First and foremost, you wanna travel with a passport. Yes, your baby needs a passport. Even if they're 1 week old, 1 year old, it doesn't matter. Baby needs a passport in order to get into different countries. What's really funny is the passport picture is so cute and they're so small and it can last them for 5 years in Canada. I don't know, the states might be different, other places in the world might be different, but for 5 years. So a five-year-old's gonna be like, here's my passport, sir, at the customs counter. And it's gonna be a photo of them when they were like 2 months old. It's really funny. All-purpose disinfectant wipes. So important to bring with you specifically for the airplanes because they are dirty and you don't want your baby touching and licking things that are gross, that have not been cleaned in months, because yes, airplanes don't get cleaned that often. So we use this to wipe down her crib, our seating area, the trays, just to keep things nice and sanitary, and they are safe for baby, this brand specifically. Also, this is huge, but I couldn't find a travel size. So what I did is I just took out some wipes and I put it into a Ziploc bag so that they stayed nice and moist and very easy to pack. Soothers are great, especially in the airplane. If you are not going to be breastfeeding or feeding your baby during takeoff and landing, get them to suck on a soother if they will take it, because it'll help them pop their ears. Also, it's great if your baby is used to a soother to calm them down. It's great to have on an airplane or just traveling in general. If you're at restaurants at nighttime, it will come in handy. Creams, I carry them for myself, specifically when I'm in an airplane. It's especially handy because it gets really dry. And I like to lather out my baby every single day, specifically after she's taken a bath. So I've got all-purpose balm, which is also good if she scratches herself, because babies scratch themselves often. I got some all-purpose balm, which is great for rashes as well as all over the body. And this one here by Eco Chic is really great, especially if your baby has eczema or extra dry spots. Disinfectant spray. This is great to have on the airplane as well as every day when you're traveling, when you don't have access to soap and water. This will do. Diapers. You need diapers, but you don't need as many as you think. Bring enough that are gonna last you throughout the flight. I'd say bring one diaper per hour you are on your flight, and enough to start you off on your trip, but you can get diapers everywhere in the world. There are babies born everywhere in the world, so don't feel like you need to bring so many with you. When we traveled, we use Huggies, disposable diapers. Now we are actually using reusable diapers, the cloth diapers, but I have not traveled with these yet. I don't know how it's gonna be. If any of you have traveled with reusable diapers, please let me know if it's possible. And I have a wet sack as well, which would be good for using a reusable diaper when traveling. But again, the whole washing thing, washing the diapers properly, I don't know how that would go down. So if you've done it, let us know. Baby wipes. So you can wipe them when they poop and they pee. And also, you don't need a lot of these. Just bring one package with you, enough to get you through the flight as well as the first couple of days when you're traveling. You can buy these anywhere in the world as well. This change pad is awesome. I highly recommend getting one. It looks kind of like a clutch, very fashionable, but it is a reusable change pad, keeps things sanitary when you're changing your baby on a flight or anywhere in a public washroom or anywhere public, really. A doggy pee pad. Yes, you can use a doggy pee pad for your human baby as well as your dog baby. I like these because sometimes you're in public washrooms and they're really extra gross, or planes are extra gross, and you don't want to use your reusable change pad. You want something that you can just toss away. So doggy pee pads, you can use them for more than just your dog. Milk! If you're breastfeeding, you're carrying your baby's buffet. So there's that. If you are not breastfeeding and you're feeding formula or whatever, just bring some bottles with you. I would recommend bringing bottled water with you on the plane, because the water that they have on the plane is kind of gross, and the filtered system is just gross. It's gross. Bring your own water and your formula. They can heat up the formula as well as breast milk for you. If you're putting breast milk in a bottle, they'll heat it up on the plane for you. Just have to ask a flight attendant, and yeah, they'll hook you up. Clothes. You want to bring comfortable clothes for your baby for the flight so that they're comfortable and they will sleep well and just be happy as possible. I love this company. I can't remember what they're called. Zippy Jams. I will link them in the video description, because you can zip it this way and you can zip it this way, so you don't have to take off everything when you're changing them. Love this company. I would also recommend bringing an extra couple pairs of outfits for the flight, especially if it's a long one, because sometimes accidents happen. And also bring extra clothes for yourself, because your baby might spit up on you and you don't want to be covered in spit up for a 7-hour flight. Blankets. Bring blankets for your baby for the flight so that they are warm as well as comfortable. You can lay it down if you get a bassinet, which, if you don't know what I'm talking about, bassinet, check out Flying with a Baby. Again, video in the iCard, check it out. But bringing extra blankets, it's good, keeps them comfortable. Hat and mitts. If you're going specifically to places that are a little on the cooler side, you want to bring hats and mitts. If your baby's bald like mine and only has the old man haircut, then definitely gonna want to bring some hats. Now when it comes to hats, you're gonna want something warm as well as a sun hat. Even if you're going to a colder destination, the sun is strong, it's there, and you don't want your beautiful baby skin to get burnt, so protect it. Bring them a sun hat. Toys. Keep your babies occupied on the flight, when you're traveling, when you're at a restaurant, having a romantic dinner with your husband or wife or whoever. You want to keep your baby occupied, bring toys that they know and love. Headphones. Yes, baby headphones. Where are my headphones at? Sweet. These little guys. These are really good if you're going to be in loud environments, even for the plane. Really good to have if your baby will put up with them on its head. Then this will keep them asleep when there's like loud announcements, or if you're going to like festivals, or just having them with you on any trip is handy, because we use them when we least expected to use them, and they really came in handy. So yeah, baby headphones. Plus they'll look so cool. A sleep sack. A sleep sack, it's like a swaddle. This one is by Halo. I love it because my baby likes having her arms out and not like swaddled in. Sleep sacks are great because they keep your baby safe. So when you're sleeping, you can have a peace of mind that your baby's not gonna have a blanket over their face in the middle of the night. Medicine. If your baby is on medicine, bring that, of course. Also bring preventative medicine, like Tylenol. That's what I brought. It's the only thing I brought, just in case baby got a fever. Yep, that's it, Tylenol. If you hear rattling, that is baby playing with her toy. Her favorite toy that came with us on our trip. Nail clippers and nail filers. Can't leave without them, because my baby's fingernails grow like every day. A lot, so I have to cut them like every day or else you'll scratch yourself. So I brought these with me. Couldn't leave the house without them. And can't forget snot suckers. They also work for you. Yeah, you don't want to travel without one of these, because if your baby gets sick or they get a plugged nose on the plane, this can help relieve that pressure. You just stick this up the nostril if you haven't seen one of these and suck. Yes, you won't get anything in your mouth, I promise. Everything that I just shared with you, I pack in this diaper bag. It all fit in this. Everything else that we put in our suitcase that we checked for Kai, our daughter, was just clothes that she wore every day. That was it. I was gone for 7 days, so I brought an outfit for each day that I was gone. So 7 outfits, plus a couple extra pairs of pants, a couple extra long sleeve shirts, and some nightwear. I was told to bring like 3 outfits per day by other people, but I thought that was a little overload. I could just wash outfits in the sink if I needed to. But if you're going for a longer period of time, like a month, I would still just pack for a week and then just do laundry. And what I did was I packed all of her outfits in Ziploc bags like this. So this would be one outfit. And it just made everything super easy. All of her socks were in here as well. Everything that she needed for the one day. So even if my husband was dressing her, I'd be like, there you go. Just toss in one of these bags and we're good to go. Booties. We brought a pair of these for the times that we didn't have Kai in her stroller and we wanted to carry her in the carrier. We wanted to keep her feet warm, so booties. And a carrier. That was probably my favorite thing we brought because it allowed Kai to face outward and basically see everything we were seeing as we were exploring different places. Just from that, I noticed such a change in her after a week of traveling through Europe. She was more curious, she was more engaged. She just had more life to her. She looked like she actually had a great travel experience and she grew as a person from that, even though she's only 4 months. Stroller and car seat. You want to have a good stroller that's collapsible, as well as a car seat if you're gonna be doing a road trip or even just going from the airport to your hotel. You can bring your own car seat if you want, but you can also rent them when you are at the destination or call taxis ahead of time and let them know that you are traveling with a baby. We preferred to bring our own because we knew we were gonna rent a car and we just wanted to have our own car seat with us. Plus, it doubled as a stroller where we could put our baby in and walk through London and Malta and all that stuff. The mommy hook. This thing came in handy so many times when we were shopping or we had our diaper bag with us and we were walking about, having this hooked onto the car seat, and then it can like hold so many bags so you're not like carrying them all yourself. Carried our camera bag. This thing is heavy duty. The mommy hook. We also brought our cover for our car seat, which keeps Kai super warm because we were going to Europe during the winter time. So that kept her so warm. And then when we decided to carry her in her carrier, we brought a onesie type jacket that also kept her very warm. And if you are breastfeeding, recommend bringing your breast pump with you. And a haka. If you don't have a haka, go get a haka. It is so good because I don't know about you, but when I'm breastfeeding, the other boob's always leaking and I don't want to waste that precious gold milk. So I just put on a haka. Can you see that?
Yeah.
And I collect the milk from the other boob and then I can pour it in a glass bottle. And there you go. You got a bottle of milk that would have just leaked onto your clothes. And that is everything we brought with us for our 1 week trip in Europe that we use. We use every single thing I just shared with you, and I'm so glad I brought everything that I did bring. Now, I wanna know if we missed something that really came in handy when you were traveling with your baby, leave a comment below, let us know. And again, there is a downloadable PDF checklist for everything that I mentioned in this video on our blog, which you can get the link to in the video description below. So be sure to check that out. All right, and for more travel with baby, be sure to check out the links in the video description as well. Okay, bye. Say bye, Kai. Bye-bye. Bye-bye, see you later. See you next time. Mwah.